since 1984. Dr. Drew Pinsky, medical doctor, philosopher, philanthropist, certified addiction specialist, the king of transformational media. Mike Catherwood, a former addict, current fitness guru, the ringmaster of the psychosexual addictive personality victim.
Loveline.
1-800-LOVE-191.
Yes, get on with it.
Oh, yeah.
Loveline, everybody. 1-800-LOVE-191 is the number to call us here in the Trojan Studios, Los Angeles, California. How are you? Dr. Drew and I had a great weekend.
Dude,
I know it for a fact.
Not bad.
Dr. Drew received an award yesterday.
Yeah.
I presented it to
him. Yes, it was nice. Thanks, Mike. I appreciate that.
We went to a nice gala. Dr. Drew is a lot of people don't know this, but Dr. Drew is a very devoted philanthropist, amongst other things, and he received an award last night because of it.
For the Hillsides Home for Children.
Yeah.
It's a really good place. Look it up.
Vulnerable children and people doing good to help their well-being, and Dr. Drew is one of those people. So we had a nice night, a lot of antics in tuxedos and fine dresses, you know?
Yeah.
So there you go. Hope you guys had a nice weekend, too. I just want to say this to Jake, the young man I met yesterday at the gala. He came up. He was a big fan of you, big fan of me. He came up and said, this goes out to you, because it was so kind of heartwarming and comical. Because he came up, he said, Mike, I'm a big fan. I've been listening to Kevin and Bean and Loveline a long time. And I was like, hey, man, thanks so much. Here's my, can you meet my girlfriend? I'll leave you alone because I know how antisocial you are. Because I've been listening. It just struck me as so crazy because it's like people do kind of know me, even if they don't know me.
Right.
And I wanted to say, you know, I am antisocial, but, you know, not in this capacity. But yeah, thank you very much.
You're antisocial in the sense when you have to isolate, but once you're out, you're good with people.
Yeah. And it was just so funny to me.
Likely
thank
protecting you from yourself.
1-800-LOVE-191 is the number. Start us off, Mike, in Huntington Beach.
Hi, I had a question. Like, earlier today I saw this video about this guy smoking alcohol on YouTube. He had a plastic bottle and he poured, you know, all different kind of booze in it. And he put, like, a cork in it with, like, an air pump, just a regular air pump with a needle, and stuck it in the bottle and just started pumping it until it was pretty stiff. And then he pulled the cork out and instantly filled with, like, a smoke. And he just started inhaling the smoke and he got drunk off of it. And I was curious, what are the side effects, if any, or if it's worse than you than drinking regular?
Right. You know, as usual, Mike, people are looking for interesting ways to ingest their intoxicants. As always, people will eye drop into their eyeballs, slip up their tongue.
Vodka-soaked tampon.
Tampons, wherever. Bongs up the tush, whatever they can do, they'll find a way to do it.
Have you heard of that before, Doctor?
Well, they have these things. Yes, I have. And they have these things out there that are called... what's it called? It's like a martini vaporizer. It's called Vapertini. And I assume it's probably built off the same physics, though I don't know. And the problem is you can't vaporize alcohol because it explodes.
Right.
I'm sorry, you can't...
you can't ignite it.
You can... Wait, vaporize?
It sort of popped when you pulled the cork out.
Right, but you can sort of, not vaporize, but turn it into droplets. You can you know, humidify.
Right.
Yeah. And
I'm so dumb scientifically, but like you can't actually change it into gas matter.
You can't, but you can turn it into droplets.
Okay.
And you can inhale it that way.
Okay.
And when they do, you know, anything that goes into your lungs obviously comes across that massive surface area that the air sacs expose the blood to, and so it goes directly to the brain. So yeah, you get very intoxicated that way, and there's concerns about people hurting themselves with it. It's a new thing, so we're not really sure what we're going to see yet.
Here's my non-medical standpoint. Don't do that. Like, just don't do that, people. God bless you, Doctor. Don't stop it, okay?
It's kind of weird that people are looking for ways to get effed up. So you know what I mean? So desperately for new ways to put things into their bloodstream. And I get that. I mean, people are always looking for a higher high and a bigger buzz and, you know, more intense experiences and stuff. But, you know, alcohol pretty much is what it is, right?
If you are eye-dropping vodka into your eyes, if you are vaporizing your alcohol, like, you have a freaking problem. Like, let me tell you, like, if you can't just casually get a buzz every once in a while... Enjoy your nice Bordeaux or glass of aged scotch. If you've got to take it to that extreme, you have a problem. Let me tell you now. I know. I'm that guy.
So you would have done this.
For sure. I, with my very rudimentary understanding of science, learned how to cook amazing crack. You know why? Cocaine didn't cut it.
Necessity.
Yeah.
What an invention.
When you're upping the ante that hard, when you're going that hard in the paint, problem.
Yeah. Well, alcohol, same thing, right?
Yes.
Same idea. Yeah.
Yes. Shannon, hello.
Consider that the beings that were co-pilot.